Hello, my name is Zoe Harkham and I'm author of The Harkham Diet. This is a special video for Father's Day and is therefore dedicated to my husband Andy and my father John. So I hope you will share this with your men, because men perhaps don't read as many magazines as women do and perhaps don't pick up little tips about their health as much as women do. And I've got some notes here to share some top information for your men and the men in your life to try and help them with many different aspects of their health. The number one tip I'd like to share with men is to stay chilled. It's so important to manage the stress in your life, men particularly. Here's an incredible statistic. Statistics show that a 35-year-old man with a blood pressure of 160 over 100 will live 16 fewer years than a man with a normal blood pressure, which we take to be 120 over 80. That's a heck of a difference in life expectancy just from having raised blood pressure, hypertension, all the indicators that you've got some serious stress going on in your life. So anything that you can do to help yourself relax, to take the pressure away, to be less of an A-type personality, is all really going to help. On alcohol, which is another important thing, we have a little tip called a 1-2 rule. Try and have one or two free alcohol days a week. So one or two days a week when you don't have any alcohol at all. And try on the other days to only be having one or two glasses of alcohol. And wherever possible, choose good alcohol. So red wine, we're quite big fans of on the Harkham Diet, so much better for you than the heavily sugared and wheat-laden beers and liqueurs. Some of the carbohydrate content in those drinks is quite incredible. So one or two glasses of red wine on quite a few days of the week, and you're really not going to feel deprived, and it's going to help your health so much. Number three, men, you need to check your bits. Women aren't great at this either. We have breast cancer, obviously, for women, and big campaigns to try and get women to check their breasts. But men, you need to check your bits as well. Now, there are three cancers which affect men only, and that's prostate cancer, testy cancer, and penile cancer. Now, prostate cancer kills the same number of men each year as breast cancer kills in women, and yet we just don't hear as much about it as we do with breast cancer. The most common age for people developing testy cancer is actually quite young. It's more prevalent in the 20 to 35 age group. So if you have actually made it into your 40s without developing testy cancer, the good news is that you're unlikely to develop it. But it doesn't mean you should have a good grope of your bits every now and again. If you spot any lumps, anything that seems a bit unusual, particularly if you ever wee blood in any circumstances, that's the time to get straight down to the GP and just have it checked out. Could be something quite simple, nothing to worry about, but get it checked out. Penile cancer is really rare at any age, so not a huge one to worry about. But again, any little changes, get down the GP and get them checked out. Now, the heart for men. Obviously, heart disease is the number one killer of men in the developed world, UK, US, for example. Many of these tips will help with your heart, eating well and being chilled and de-stressing your life. But the single most important thing you can do for heart health is to not smoke. So if any of you do still smoke or trying to give up, if you care about your health in any way, shape or form, it is the single biggest thing you can do to improve your health. So all the effort needs to go into doing that, and people around the men in your life, please do what you can to help them, because it is so difficult to give up smoking, but you really, really have to try. If you can't give up, cut down, cut down, cut down as much as you possibly can. And the final tip, because I am a diet author at the end of the day, is the other great thing that you can do for your health, guys, is to eat real food. And you have led the way in this. You've been the meat eaters, the fish eaters, the omelette eaters, the cheese eaters, the red wine drinkers. Carry on that great work. Don't let any female tell you that you should be living on Special K or muesli bars or rabbit food or low-fat cottage cheese or any of that rubbish. Carry on eating food as nature has delivered it, because you are the cavemen originally, and that's what the cavemen have always eaten, and that's what we need to carry on eating today. So I hope this has helped. Have a wonderful Father's Day, and if you do get any red wine, enjoy it as we've given you the tip for. Thanks very much for listening.